Hello and good day everyone. So today I will be I'm making this video in order for us to catch up all week 1, 2 and 3 coverage for this video demonstration. So I will discuss here. Maybe I will just make a fast track for the introductory, then we will proceed directly to the content of this presentation, no? So I prepared here a presentation regarding our topic for today. It's all about the Saturn workshop. We will be focusing on the Python programming language. Okay, and at the same time I'm also using the LMS of the DICT so that we can have a glimpse on how to program your Python programming. And I hope you already prepared the IDE, which is the PyCharm community edition. So I choose PyCharm community because this is free to use, no? And at the same time this is very light when it comes to the other programming IDE of the Python. So actually there are lots of them, so you can use also VS Code if you want to, as long as you have the necessary tools for the plugins of the Visual Code if you want to. But I prefer PyCharm para purely Python lang yung iyang mabasa. Sa VS Code, may mga instances na nga sometimes may mga ano sa bala, may mga plugins nga naga sometimes naga conflict sa iyang nga IDE mismo hanggang sa iyang mga plugins or mga extensions nga ginagamit. So that is why we will focusing on the Python language alone, no, which I recommend the PyCharm. Anyway, PyCharm also is being used, no, by the excuse me, by the different company that program purely of a Python programming language. So without further ado, we will start our lesson. So we will be starting with the chapter 1 of our, no, the week 1 sang aton nga lesson. So that will be getting started with your Python. So, and I know most of you is familiar with the Python, so that's why I making some of the fast track on the in introductory so that we can come up with the code directly. Okay, now, so when you say Python, it is a high level interpreted, no, as I've said, interpreted, although it is a programming language, but ang iyang purpose kit is to interpret the code of e Python, no, unlike C and C++, no, nga may arag sa iyang interpreter na may compiler, may assembler, no. So amo man di ang ano niya, pero most of the time gina-interpret yung mga code niyo because sa Python is a continuously evolving programming language. Because it can adapt any ano, no, any sort of cross platform, no, ng mga programming language, no. It can be read on the Django, it can read on the mobile and any other platform that can interpret Python programming. So that's why high level interpreted general purpose sa mga programming language. So the syntax ng Python is also refer to the similarly sa inyong Java or C++. Kaya mo ni mga mother of ano ng programming language, no, nag-start sila man sa C, no. So the language founded in the year 1991 by the developer Guido von Rosso, no. So has the programming easy and fun to do. So but during our time, programming language na Python is not that popular. There was a time that when I take the NC4 exam in programming level number 4, no? Fortunately nakapasa man si sir niyo. There was one, no, faculty, I mean maestro, no, or teacher sa college nga gatud nga siya lang gid isa, no. So tanang kami nag-handle puro tanang Java, C++. The only one that is eager to finish all of the tasks, no, in assessment in TESDA, si nalipat yung name niya, but si Python ang gamit niya. So that's why Python that time is not that popular, but still it is using also interpreted programming language na si Python. Now, ang iyang structure daw, ano man yapon daw, C and Java man yapon. During our time, Java and C++ that time is the most popular programming languages, no? During our time. So that was before, way back 2006 then 2007. But anyway, so this is the ano, no? This is Sir Guido Van Rossoff, no? Yeah. So medyo, at least may edad na siya. Anyway, yan sir. So it is Rusom. Mr. Rusom is a Dutch programming programmer, best known as the author of Python programming language, no? For which was the benevolent dictator for life, no? Until he stepped down from to the position in July 2018. No? So meaning na doon nag-retire na siya. But anyway, siya ni aton yan na ancestor with ancestor niya. So siya ni aton niya to look up why we have this transformation of data right now because of the Python programming language and because of this person. So we owe our data professionals nowadays because of this person. No? But anyway, I will not the profile of this person. So Python is widely used in bigger organizations because of its multiple programming paradigm. No? As I've said a while ago, Python is a continuous programming language. No, kaya evolve sa each and every time that there is a new one coming on the technology, no, mapaharaman sa Google, sa Microsoft, or any other ng mga technology that comes up on the technology, Python is also there, no, ga-update man si Python, no. So it has a comprehensive and large standard library and has automatic memory management and dynamic features. So that's why it is open source, no. Magsin lang open source ta, so pwede ka maka-contribute sa community, no, sa iyang mga libraries and packages, just like the same sa other mga programming language nga free man, no. Just like I think, no, si Laravel ata daw ano man daw open source man siya, so pwede ka maka-contribute. B4A is also a open source, but there are some components nga medyo may bayad, pero bayad hindi license, no. Kung sinta nga may bayad, diyan ma-subscribe ka lang if you want to cut off the subscription. So just ma-stop man sa unlike licensing ya nga build nga package, no, yung mga background, no? So mo nang iya nga nga kinalain sang open source and at the same time naka-license or naka-purchase product, ha? Okay, so again, no, as mentioned to a while ago, professionally, Python is a great for back-end web development, data analysis, artificial intelligence, and scientific computation. So, amuning iya yung pinaka-strong and strength, no, sang Python programming language, no. Hindi lang saya kay pang-program lang, but it can also for use for the different branches with regards to our development, and at the same time not only on the development side but also on the analysis and artificial intelligence, no, the machine learning and so on. So amo ning iya yang strength gid ya, which is amo ba na ang demand subong, no, with regards to the mga neural network, no, mga machine learning, no, blockchain technology. So ga-involve na da ang programming language ng si Python, no? So that's the strength of this programming language, because as I've said, no, it is a continuously evolving programming language, no. Maka-adapt saya sang change, no, when it comes to that, because as I've said, it is an open source. You can contribute on the library if what are the needed library on the existing or the incoming technology, no? O nang kung kumera nga mga technology nga naga evolve. So continuously naga ano sa na gradually naga evolve siya. So naga evolve man si Python because of the contribution of the different maybe individual to contribute the library for the Python to improve. So that's why it is very open source na pwede ka mga contribute if you want to. So many developers have also used Python to build productivity tools, you know, just like such as games and desktop apps. So there are plenty of resources to help you to learn on how to do this, all those things kinds of system or applications, no? So using the Python alone. Now, so a simple history of the Python, as I've said, no, siya nina nag-create si Guido Van Rossum, no? So it was created on the Netherlands, no, eventually released on the public distribution in early 1981. Okay, so it was being conceived on late 1980s, no? So dito sa nag first kin, no, sa 1980s, so wherein ang internet that time medyo gina-implement na sa market, almost, no, introduced sa market. Pero ang first siguro implementation is on in 1989 of this person, no? Tapos gin-release kin sa publicly on 1991, no? Since most of the modern OS are written in C, no, during our time, so mostly to ya C gito yung among ginagamit. So ang pinakauna ko nga programming lang sinagamit is DQ Basic, no, which is purely DOS based, and at the same time not only DOS based but the text based kind of programming language. And the nice thing right now is Python is also can be run on the .NET. I'll just download the necessary plugins, no. So muna ka ano ka flexible ka tama kay ano kay Python. And at the same time pwede naman sa iba niya pag niya mga IDE na pwede man ka maka-download at actually mga plugins niya kag mga libraries siya siyempre. Kay since na open source siya, you can download it anyway. Okay, how did it all begin? So the languages are usually born from one to two motivations, no? Large well from a funded research project, or normally it is a general frustration due to the lack of tools, no? Amo ni siya ang mga normally ginya mga instances kung gusto mo may ara ka i-develop. Sa iba niya mga programming language that like C and C++, para ma-develop ni sila, so dapat may well-funded kaya ganyan nga research project. So syempre, dapat ibalik man ang favor sa nag-fund. No? So mo sila nga nag-contribute sila sa imo, so meaning dapat may alaman niya yung ROI or return of investment. Pero kung wala gid, so normally, they were needed at a time to accomplish the mundane and time-consuming task. Medyo malawig-lawig lang siya ubrahong galing. Just like any other programming language. Just like Ruby, no? Ruby nga programming language created by a Japanese person, no? So, funded man siya sang a certain siguro mga organization. Pero, kung do hindi kung wala sa mga fund sa mo, then most probably, ikaw gidang ma-fund for your own, no? So mangita ka lang mga investor later on kung daw makita nila nga may ara ano ba lang, potential ang imo nga project. So the other organization or company they found siguro that the Python has a potential, that's why they funded, no? Kay as I've said, no, sa ang gagina lang yun. Na ang Python that time ng programming language is not that ano popular during our time, so mga 2000, mga 2004, 2005, 2006, it's not actually popular, no, ang programming language. Hindi siya ganibati agit sa ano, the name Python is not considered as popular, no, even the name itself, no. However, because of the maybe, no, well, I'm not saying that the Python is ano, no, na market din siya, so most probably Mr. Guido, no, Ross no, or Mr. Guido he tried his best, most probably, to market the Python programming language so that it can be funded and continue para ma ano sa ma continue ang iyang research and the project itself. And I think Mr. Guido is also successful, no? Found out to be successful. Fortunately, naging successful siya because of his dedication on this legacy of programming language, no? You just like the same sa COBOL, no? The common business oriented language, no? or COBOL. So si COBOL that time hindi man ano ganik ay daan na ganyan ng programming language, but until now may nagagamit yapon sa COBOL kag in develop pa gid siya. So that's the ano, no, that's the advance or the advantage kung may nagamarket and at same time may nagasupport or nagafund sa imong project, no? Because we don't know kung ano ang mga project later on nga mga come up, no? Most probably maybe on your batch there will be a certain project or research project that will be useful to the community, and you know, hindi tagi niya mabalaan ang ano, no, ang ginatawag nga future, because most ma ano kaya, no, ma do ka unpredictable ba nya, maybe later on base ang imong research project na today wala siya ginasapak, maybe tomorrow, no, or for the next coming year or in the near future base maano siya, no, makilala bala, guys, no, just like other nga mga country like ano bala ang perte pa himuon, no, ng mga patent, mga research bala ng mga wala diri wala dito man sa nga ano mo nga mga patent, no, as long nga ang patent nga na nga gin-develop mo, gin-create mo, gin-invent mo, wala sang parihas kag purely bag-o lang gyud, no, fresh from the ano, fresh from the tree na puksi. Pero you will not know, no, if that kind of research will be fruitful someday. So that's why as starting sa inyo nga, no, nga young age, so you try to think something out of the box nga maka-research ka mo sa mga project that can be useful in the community, no, if that research project, no, doesn't have any ano pa man, no, mga parehas pala, guys, no, wala sang pareho, wala sang ibang pagidang, no, as in newly invented gyud, then we can put it on the patent, no, basi pila ka law magamit siya. Okay, but anyway, do naglawig na ko da, so we will just go for the history of the Python anyway. So at the time, Van Rossum was a researcher with a considerable language design experience in interpreted with language ABC, also developed in CWI, or Centrum Wiskindi, na pronounced as Wiskulu, meaning the mathematics, no, grabe yung ilang sa mathematics, no, sa Amsterdam, no, so mo nang ilay kung din sa nag-start. Okay. Some of the tools he envisioned were the performing general system administration tasks. So, muna-una, gidya nga, na purpose ni Python. Then, after that, gin, ano siya, no? Founded on this part of the institution, organization, on the NWO-I, while located in Amsterdam Science Park. So, those are the, ano, malanggays, no? So, about that, put it on the verbatim gid ang iyang ano, no, so at least you know the where does the Python being developed and created, no, so meaning ara gid sa tanan nga sa Netherlands, no, so muning ang portion sang aton nga map, no, wherein ang Netherlands, no, kundin siya nato pa normally ang mga Netherlands ara sa mga European country. So, din nag-exist or nag-born ang aton niya Python programming language. Okay? May nangani kay sa Asia, ara si, ano, no, ang Ruby. Si Ruby, si, ano mo, Japanese person na siyang, ano mo, ang nag-create. Okay, so anyway, that's just i-map. So where does the Python name come from? I mean, kado kanyo niya, no? Python, yun yan. Okay, now. When he began to implement Python, okay, Mr. Luzon was also reading the public script from the Monty, a Python Flying Circus, no? So nagguro nakita niya nga enthusiast with regards to the name. Just like the same on the Java, no? Kasi sila yung medyo na they love coffee. So where they are they have a break, no? Tapos nagganan sila isang cup of coffee, no? Sa isa ka, most probably sa cafe. Then they found out the name of the Java, doon mo nang ila, doon ka nahiling ila, then they renamed the programming language to Java. Just ano lang, doon. Kung mga phantom mind na siya, mga ano, no, out of nowhere, they created the name just like that, no? Because they have do may peculiar sa isa ka mga word, no, nga ginatawag. So that's why kung may makita ka nga Java gani dumiyara gina nga cup of coffee, no, nga naga normally ang i-icon do nag-aso-aso na sa nga kanya. So diri naman yun, di naman nakita sa may Monty Python Flying Circus. Maybe ano kung i ano mo si kung i-assess mo siguro si Mr. Guido. So normally si Mr. Guido yung loves siguro sa ginatawag nga to read at the same time sa mga circus, probably most probably, no, but not na but I'm not saying that Mr. Rusov is ano is a fan with the circus, ano lang ng mga just a hint nga si Mr. Rusov na minsan sa mga scripts na minsan sa mga circus. Okay, wait lang. So why companies prefer Python? So muna sang pinakadako ganyan pamangkot. If you have observed, no, dumadamo klase ng mga programming language niyo. Okay? Python has top of the chart, no, in the recent years over the programming language of C and C++ and Java and widely used by the programmers, no. The language has undergone the drastic changes since it released in 25 years ago, no, as many add-on features are introduced. Nung sila nga doon, naman yung mga library yung ginapang-add nila sa kay Python, no? Okay. So the first version, no, nga gin-introduce is the Python 1.0, no? Mayara sa nga module 3, interface with the Amoeba operating system with the various function tools. Tapos, naman na, nag-evolve siya sa 2.0, nga mayara sa garbage collector, just like the same on Java. No, may garbage collector na siya, no. Kung sila nga garbage collector mo nang sa memory nga dump, no. Para ma-minimize sila sang memory usage, so they need to have a garbage collector. Kay without knowing, guys, no, without knowing Java programming language and Python is actually very ano, no, very heavy with regards to the memory. And so very heavy siya, katama, no. Kung try niyo magano bala mag-program kamo kay Sir Julius, tapos nag-open kamo, if I'm not mistaken, it's NetBeans, no. Tawo niyo kung mag-load si NetBeans, grabe ang loading niya, no. With kung depende sa specifications ng inyong ano nga laptop or even your desktop, medyo at least medyo hinay ang iyang ano nga loading, kay grabe ang gamit niya sang imo nga memory, no, nga utilization sang memory. So that's why gagamit sila sang mga garbage collector nga mga ano nga mga classes para ma-minimize ang ano ang ma-optimize ang memory allocation sa imo nga PC, para at least makasarang man ang mga low specs nga mga PC, especially during sa mga 2005, 2006, 2007, medyo ano siya, medyo ang memory hindi pa muna kaano kid, no, ka sophisticated, no. Ang mga memory that time mga 1 gig, mga 2 gig, no, GB, no. So doon muna kaano, doon mo lang challenge that time sa mga programming language on how to optimize the memory. So do actually do halos na niya mga ano ng mga programming language, do doon mo nang ilaging dilemma with regards to the specification of the computer. Because actually, no, nang miski magambal pa tanga kung ano pa nga programming language ang ginagamit natin, whether we like it or not, maano gina sila, mahulam gid sang amount of memory allocation sa imong PC. So that's the dilemma of all, I mean, programming language, no? Sige. Then it evolved to 3.0. So it was introduced in the year 2008. So amo ni sang time nga nagapa ko mga ano mga NC4 sa testa. So the software development companies prefer Python language because it is versatile, no? Features and fewer programming codes, no? That's the nice thing lang galing sa Python. Ang mahimo ta nga iba yung mga codes sa mga Java sometimes and C++ medyo laba. Medyo fewer lang ang codes ang mabilin. Kahit tungod si Python mismo, ang mga libraries niya, dogin butang na dito ang mga lagba nga mga codes. Ang aton yung mga 10, 1 to 10 yung mga line of codes, ginihimo na lang yun ni Python, at least mga 2 to 3 codes na lang. So at least makasave-save ka sa mga memory niya. So that's why medyo interpreted sa ni ano no ni Python, no? So nearly 14% of programmers use it on operating system like such as your Linux, your Unix, ang Unix dahil na nagaling si C and C++, Windows and Mac OS, no? So amo na subong ang demand, no? Now, so the programmers of big companies use Python as it has created the mark of itself of the software development with the characteristic features such as your interactivity, interpreted, modular, dynamic, object-oriented, which is very important, portable, high-level, and extensible in C++ and C. Masilingon, pwede mo ma-extend ang imong code sa C and C++. Kay since drama nagaling si Python, sa duwa na siyang language. Na? High level is because gina-interpret yun ang tanan niya mga different libraries, no, nga naka-inculcate sa iya. Take note ha, naman sa ganit, open source. So meaning, high level lang yung siya kay damo nag-contribute sa community with regards to the Python. So meaning, the more nga nag-damo nag-contribute, that means to say, ang iya nga libraries, nag-complicated man. So that's why the high level siya. Easy to learn, easy to read. Maybe easy to learn. Kay tungod, ang imo nyo lang get is to search for the documentation of the said classes lang or library. For example, may magamit ka ba isang ano ba, pandas, no? Nga library. Ang imo mo lang get is to download, no? And install the package of yung panda. Tapos, i-ano mo lang, tunaan mo lang kada documentation sang library of the panda, NumPy, in any other packages relating to the Python. So that's why it's so easy to learn gimas sa somehow kung may time ka mag-read, no. So ang importante lang gid kabalo ka lang mag-interpret, mag-comprehend sang mga packages ni Python, no. So easy to read, to maintain, robust, no. Secure ka tama. No? As you have observed, no? No? Linux, no? As you have said, Linux, Unix. So medyo mawulay siya makurap. It's because of the robustness, no? Protective ka tama. Effective sa rapid prototyping tool. Mas yung nga rapid, kung tasigay, no? Nga prototyping tool. Then we have a memory manager because may sa garbage collector. At the same time, interpreted, the byte, no, compile. So meaning, just like the same on the other programming languages. So interpreted sang bytes natin. Anyway, kami sang compiler, interpreter, and assembler. So mangyayang, the present C and C++. Okay? And Java also. Now, so who are the company using it? So umani sila mga company, so I will not discuss it anymore. Then we have this one. Now, I think some of you familiar with all of the companies here. Just like this. I don't know if Nokia kung harap pag Japan, but I think Nokia is still there. But it was being bought by Microsoft. And also Yahoo. Yahoo, I don't know if Yahoo is still there, but I think Yahoo is also being purchased by the Google company. Now, correct me if I'm wrong if kung ang ano gimana. Kay normally kay daw si Yahoo subong daw wala naman gid ano no, daw wala naman gid sa batia si Google na lang ang almost gid daw ang batia gid sa mga ano din, sa mga giant company. And I think if I'm not mistaken, daw gin ano ni siya, daw gin matama sa purchase ni ano ni Google, no? Okay? And this one, so medyo nag-a-updates ano, from the smaller one, then it gradually increasing from the different company and giant companies, and today there are lots of companies right now who are using the Python. So meaning if you try to observe your all the company, kung tungaon ng inyong sections, pwede kayo actually ka-apply one by one, no? So meaning to say you need to study also the Python. So that's why I introduce this to you, para at least you have an experience on how to program Python. Okay? So ano mga plus points ni ano ni Python, no? So syempre una, easy to use, expressive language, no? Interpreted, medyo ano lang siya galing, medyo ma-follow ka lang sa structure niya. Kaya kumagambag ka ng block statement, as in block statement ka dyan. Unlike C and C++ in Java, miski na ka-block statement ka, pwede mo siya gyapon niya nga naka, nga do ano bala, nga do matyag mo do nagka-program kaya sa ano, sa puron talang ano left side tanan, no? Unlike sa mga IDE, isubo niya ka na mag-enter ka do naga ano, naga-block statement ng iyang nga structure, no? From the start of the heading or the importation of the library, then go to the main body, etc. and so on and so forth. So medyo naga-block na siya. Pero pwede mo siya i-gyapon niya ma-insert niya, ma-idog ang iyang nga placement. Diriya sa kay ano, sa kay Python, medyo stricto lang siya gamay sa pag ano, sa pag-construct ng structure niya. Kaya kung magamba tabi nga pag if ni mo be, ang tabi na gano ka be. Kung ang if ni mo normally pwede tayo ka ano mo tanan niya mga statement kaya rata na sa left side. Subong niya lain. Excuse me. So may ara siya nga, no, nga structure nga dapat kung magambal tayo pag enter ya bisang IDE mo be kung ang iyang structure be naging dense sa be at least mga half inch of ano of the indent amo ginayang iyas placement kay kung ipahigad mo siya, no, so ga error siya, so do medyo amo lang nang iya nga nya kinalain sa iba. So but most ano lang, so to make the story short, is to use mo sa gyapon. Kaya at least hindi ka na mag-idog-idog. Mano ko na lang, inter ko na lang, tapos type ko na lang sa mga code. So it is an interpreted language, no? It's complete, its completelessness. Cross-platform, as I've said a while ago, na pwede sa maka code, I mean, ang iya nga code, pwede ma-blend sa iba niya mga programming language. Free and open source, because you can contribute to the community of the Python. Variety of usage in application because it transform on the different component, no, such as the data professionals, data engineering, data science, machine language, artificial intelligence, no? So those are interactivity, modular, dynamic, object oriented, this is very important, portable, high level and extensible in C and C++. Itong pwede siya ma-blend sa C and C++. And yeah, so doon mo nang iya nga mga plus points niya. Easy to learn, to read, to maintain, robust, effective, and rapid prototyping tool, and so on. So, kamo na lang bahala basa. Kaya actually, damo ni sila. No? Ang iya nga mga plus points. So, ano mga disadvantage niya naman? Speed. No? Magsamalita nga speed, kung damo na library nga kang ginagamit, tapos damo na siya yung mga integration, then the speed is one of our disadvantage here. Kaya mahulat gid ka mo. No? Unlike sa mga compiling sa Java kag C++ niya, pero kay nagadepende sa kalabao naman. Dali naman niya, misi gamay lang yung mga code kag dawa ka integration sa ibang niya mga component, no, sa lain-lain niya yung mga packages. Kaya sin sa mga packages niya, pwede mo man lang ma-download itself on the command prompt of your Windows or Mac or any other nga pro nga ano galit ng mga operating system. So medyo may mahina gyud ang iya nga ano nga efficiency, no, sa pag-interpret. Kasi as I have said, no, ang mga packages na sana halin sa mga lain-laing mga contributor sa ano mo sang sang Python. So that's why medyo ang iya nga pag-interpret niya, pag-compile niya from the native code down to the mga packages niya, tapos ibutang niya pa na sa may assembler, then go to the machine language and go back again to the native code to give us a result. So medyo may argument siya nga efficiency wise, medyo hinay gyud man ang iyang ano nga compiling. As long nga arap man lang nila. Ang speed ya subong nowadays hindi naman wala naman na subong ginatulog kay ang taton subong mga PC naton medyo taas naman gid ang specs. So that's why ang speed ya depende man sa gyapon sa specs ang inyong computer. Mobile development, easy to maintain, memory consumption. Magsiling nga easy to maintain, medyo may ano lang kamali guys ha, kay each and every time ga-update ni. So dapat kung butang tabi, 3 months from now, may ala na mabag-o be ang iwa be nga package nga panda. Butang tabi, ang pandas mo be nga package. Di, pag after 3 months, may update naman. So i-update ko naman. Although medyo ano lang, medyo keen ka lang sa update, tapos basa ka lang always ang ilang ano, nga website kung ano nga mga updates ng bago para ma-download mo man or ma-update man yung mga packages. Basi, time will come, basi may mga libraries ka na nga hindi na amo ang pangalan. For example, labi isang, when I was in sa akong binga gina-part-time man, no, may arat nga ang iya nga package is sa itong name na nalipat ko sa name niya. Then, I found out that the name medyo nag-change na. So, pero ginambalan ka man sa ano, sang command prompt nga ang ini nga package is not already supported, so instead of using this using you download the package of this, so meaning i-download mo gid ang package nga gina suggest sang Python na programming language. So that's why medyo ano man sa medyo ano lang medyo keen lang kamo sa maintenance niya. So memory consumption, as I've said, no, so hindi siya actually ano gid na for the ano gid sa mga lower specs ng mga unit, as much as possible at least nami ang specifications sa mga nga device. So database access, more only sa gali guys sa mga back end, no. So ang mag database access ka, gamit ka lang sa ibang nga mga tools niya such as Django, no, pwede na. So pwede ka takabutang database access. Okay, so normally bido ano sa do back end database at back end ano yung ano na interpretation. So pwede yan ma-interpret ang imo mga data through data sets. Sa database pwede man magamit lang kamo sang different nga mga ano ya, nga mga distribution sang iya nga mga ano nga language, no? Such as Django, pwede na. Then we have runtime error. Yan, so medyo ano siya, stricto, no. Not strong on type binding or dynamic typing. So medyo wala daw ano ang iya nga ano ang dukaan siya, case sensitive, no. Python is in evolving, no, and evolving in continuously. Sila yung nag-evolve sa termi, no, kay nag-transform mga ton niya ano ng mga technology gaupod si Python sa iya nga evolution. Not a great choice for high graphic 3D game. Okay, designs issue, memory consumption. Magsalita guys nga design issue ang iyang structure ni guys ha. So basi nga gambar ka mga sakto man ang tanan niya code niya gipakita ni San Mandia, pero doon nag-error gaya po, no. Wala man sa wrong spelling doon na blah. Do wala man syntax nga nag-change. Doon gin-check mo verbatim ang imong code pero nag-error gaya po. Because of the design issues ng iyang structure. So i-follow mo yun. So umunang iyang daw disadvantage niya. Nga mo ito doon na mention doon ang redundant kung memory consumption. Then we have simple rules. So those are the disadvantage of the Python. Huh? So ano mga compilers and interpreter naton? So umunang iyatan mga ano na, I think you're already familiar with the ano naman with the compilers na kung paano siya nag-execute, no? From the native code down to the assembler, then blah blah blah, etc. Pakagto sa itong machine language, then go back again to the user. Okay? Ayan, so umang ilang mga ano, interpreter, compiler, and the assembler. So, again, no, it is an open source ang Python, ta? So, umang yung mga distributions ang ato niya mga Python, no? Some of the Python distribution are the Acted Python, Anaconda, no, which is very popular. No, kaya ang Anaconda niya daw halos tangan niya mga IDE, daw yun inculcate na kaya Anaconda. You download only Anaconda, then all of the necessary IDE pertaining to Python, ah, Python Japon tanan, are already there on the Anaconda. O galing, ang Seb said a while ago, medyo at human actually si Anaconda. No? Kay gagamit ka mo Python, medyo mas burubog at human sa actually si Anaconda. Ayan. So, ma-download nyo rin sa guys sa, ano, sa iyang website ni Anaconda. You can download the latest version. So, once you download it, makita nyo na guys, ang pati ang PyCharm actually, ano na, na-included na kay Anaconda. So, ang umbot silingon, ma-ano ka lang na guys, mapili ka lang sang imong IDE nga gamiton. Pero purely, puro mo na tanan, ano, puro mo na tanan Python, gyapon ang iyang code ang ginagamit. No? Marada ibang Jupiter, marada ibang Spider, no? Kagiban pa din yung mga programming, anong mga IDE, ah. Pero Python, mag-gyapon ang iyang nga code ang ginagamit. Okay? Yan, may pwede man Canopy. Ayan, so muna nga guys nga distribution, no? Magsiling nga distribution, bilara lang isa kapag ano da, may at least damo na sa magamit na sa mga distribution niya. So, sila ni nga apat ang most commonly no, ng mga distribution. No? Then may araman Chinese project. No? So, sikat Japan si Chinese. No? So, mga classes niya are written into Chinese translation of the Python. No, kay siling ko na ng ginap, ano, a while ago, nga si Python yung is very, ano, very open source. Yeah. Medyo may disadvantage lang galing kay open source, eh, no? Kay, since nga open source siya. So, I don't know if, ano, if ang iyang nga shell is, ano, is very strong when it comes to the intrusion with regards to the other parties. No? And I think, you know what I mean with the regards of the security, no? May ginatawag. But tayo, miyara, sa sumang ginahin mo ang translation sa ng mga codes naman for the Chinese versions. No? So, kay, ano na siya mo, open source, so, you can do anything as long na naka-part ka sa community. No? Kung tanda ka naging niya mag-create sa mga classes, mga libraries, pertaining to the Python program, or I mean programming languages. So gina-interpret man lang sa yan ni Python nga dala na sa ano, sa library sa iyang documentation. So amo man ang importante diyan. Okay? So let's proceed to the IDE na ginagamit no sang Python. Actually damo sila kag amo to gani ginambal ko. You can download the Anaconda and there are pilaman do mga guro mga 10 to 11 or 12 or more than 10 no ng mga IDE ang pwede niyo magamit. Pero syempre hindi niyo pag gamiton tanan. So pili lang kamo ya sang IDE nga pamatsagan niyo do mas mahapos gamiton kag do medyo ano kamo ng familiar. Amo tanga ni PyCharm sa bunga to ni introduce. Pero mas mayo gid ako naka stand alone gid no compared to the Anaconda kay una bisa tanan. Si Anaconda ya pag open na siya i-load niya na yung Anaconda pag ano sang Anaconda nga application plus tara niya kasang damo-damo IDE tapos sa mga IDE da pwede mo na ma-install ang iban no ng mga IDE no para lang din magamit mo so pero pwede man standalone so that's why magamit ya PyCharm standalone na lang para hindi ta niya pagsabadon si Anaconda kasi Anaconda ya ma-occupy memory pag-install mo kay PyCharm, for example, using Anaconda, man-Japon, magamit yung man-Japon sa Anaconda ng application. Doka mo na guys, doka hassle, no? But sila mong mahulam kagad yung memory sa imo PC. I mean, ma-occupy ka memory sa imo nga PC, matama agad ka kabugat. So, that's why, download lang ka mga standalone, no? Ayan, so, muna yung mga IDE na to, no? So, we have ang GitHub yun ang Ninja IDE na yak GitHub. You have the Spider. So, ang mga ginagamit naman sa masteral naman. So, for now, huwag ko na sa ginagamit kay kay doon na lipat ako. So, ang ako naman sabog niya, tulad ng pie chan naman, kay Jupiter notebook. So, you have Eclipse, if you want to, medyo buka pag ini. Then, you have Django. Then, we have Pie Scripter. Then, Beware, Coaster Diaries. Then, Eric, Exodor. Exodor, I mean, sorry. Then, we have your Pie Chan, one of the. Tapos, Jupiter notebook. Komodo, IDE. Tagda mo actually guard na guys no sa inyo ng mga IDE nga pwede niyo magamit. And one of them I think is VS Code. Sublime pwede man. Hindi yung VS Code man. Sorry. Ay, wala nang mention sa VS Code. Eh, wait lang. I think talaga yung VS Code. Aman sing si ano, no, si Anaconda Navigator. Eh, no, dumdamo sa guys ano. Namo sa mga IDE nga pwede niyo magamit. Wait lang. Ito nga isang VS Code man. I think you're familiar with man. VS Code, are you... Wala. But actually, pwede ka maka-download VS Code. Kaya ako naka-download ako VS Code. VS Code pwede ko magamit. Okay? Pwede mo ako magamit. Ha? Jupiter, hindi ko namin asin kay, ano, kay Jupiter. Kaya ito ka-browser base. Gatalan ko nito isang, ano, isang Jupiter notebook. But I always use gid sang mga IDE Arab lang guys nga ano gid bla nang do ka ga code gid ya ano tayo yon nga na code do ko bigay ka sa sang kasi ano be si Jupiter notebook mag code gid ni siya be per ano per console per console siya sorry yo Masiling mo kung sa drive kung ang i-testingan mo lang is line number 3, 4, and 5. So, pwede mo yan ma-ano, ma-filter out. Pero kaya doon hindi ko nakasaw. Doon na, medyo nga daan ng ako niya nga coding sa IDE. Ya. Ano, medyo continuous. No? Kung mag-compile sa continuous. Mo. So, makoncentrate sa kay PyChart. Ano na yan kung yun. Okay? So anyway, that is the introductory and this presentation will also be uploaded on our GC also. Wait lang. So ma-proceed to sa aton nga introductory sa Python ta. As I've said, no, created by Guido van Rossum. Okay? So ang syntax niya, do pares magyapon sa C, no? C and C++. Ang kinalain lang kay si C is gagamit sa isang preprocessor nga less than, double less than symbol. Area do ka parehas sa kay C. Kay C siya galing niya may if and do print if no? Ang kay C. So si ano ya, si si Python print lang. So example, be ma-open ko dano, new project. You can follow this video anyway if you want to. Okay? So, all you need to do is to name the project. Tabi, this is my Python. Ay, sorry. One minute lang. My Python. Sorry. Python project. Jex para lang. Okay? So, if you want to put it on the Git repository if you want to. No, but kung since nga wala akong internet sa PUP sa Comlab 1, so no need na nga magbutang sa Git. But if you want to synchronize your file from the local then go to the cloud, you can use the repository of the Git na if you want to. Okay? Then we will just put it on the location you want to save no, the project. So on my part, I will be using this drive bay. Then ma-add lang ko directory. So I will make it Python project. Oh, may Python codes na lang. Okay na lang. Okay din. Ayan. So muna natin my Python project. Ay. Sige, muna na. Okay, and then we will be using na Python version depende sa inyo gamitan. No? So what we will be using the latest version. No? The Python 3.12.0. Okay? So after that, you may click create. Alright. Wait lang, dali lang. Doon nag-update ako niya, no? Okay. Ayan, so nag-update din sa NAC ko. Dahil lang ganyan. Ayan. So, from a Python project, so ma-create ko new, then you have file. Okay, ang file ko be, for example, my first Python program. Ayan. So, though ka pareho lang yapon sa aton nga ginagamit nga typical ng mga IDE. So, you can actually directly go for the code. No, instead, no, sa C++ normally ma-declare ka include, iostream, etc. and so on and so forth. No? Dre, you can go directly for the print. That's a nice thing. Then, you put here, for example, hello world. Ayan. Then, you can run it anyway. Just run. Oops. Ayan. Okay, doon nag-ano pa siya. Okay, may mga... Wait lang guys, ha? Hindi lang yan. Okay, sorry guys. No, delete ko liwat ang ano. ang file. So, pag right-click nyo, new file. Okay, sorry na. Nalipat ko ba. So, pag new file nyo, don't forget to put the .py na extension nila. So, that's why hindi ma-interpret. Okay? So, anyway, sorry siya. My first Python program .py. So, meaning Python ang iyang interpretation. So, we will just put print again. Then we have hello. Hello. World. Ayan. So, when you try to click run, aring run tao. Run, then apply na lang. Name, option. Okay, then get multiple option. Live configuration setting correct. Wait lang. Done. Okay. Wait lang guys, ha. Okay guys, medyo may ano lang tanong. May ano lang ang gamay sa aton nga setup. So wait lang. So sulitong ko liwat. I'll just close the pie chart. Wait lang. Okay. So to do this, wait lang. Damo mga open ako na. Okay. So once you open the pie chart, okay, no? So, let me repeat it again. Lang para at least makita nyo kung paano sa amin. So, I'll just remove the main.py. So, reset delete. And also, I will be deleting also the ano. Close ko na lang liwat. Sorry. So, i-close ko na lang liwat. Tagto ko to sa drive D. Okay, nag-create ko to Python project. Python project. So just remove this one. Yeah, para solid is from the scratch. So when I try to open the PyCharm, yeah, so I'll just remove this. Okay, so mag-create new project. So sa dire, make sure lang ang locations ang inyong file, no, maibutang always. So meaning may redirect this always, you save the file. So let's say for example Python project, then let's say for example inside the Python project is computer workshop. Okay? And then ang name na di ko anong pangalan sa inyong project nung naka-folder mo na siya actually ng iyang brand. So butang tabi, this is a test sample. Okay? That's it. So if you want to create a welcome script, pwede man. So you just uncheck if you don't want to. Okay? Then, as you have observed, we have the interpreter natin. We have the project bin, or you can base Anaconda or custom environment. So let's say for example, we will just use the environment, with the virtual environment. No? So once you're done with the name and at the same time the location, if you want to save your file or your Python program, so just create. Okay, ayan. So, wait lang. Okay, ga-load pa. Wait lang. Okay, so sa dere, pwede na ka mag-create ng inyong project. No? So, sa dere yung library root. So, right-click lang ka muna. So, you have file, then you have Python file. So, Python file, for example, is, let's say, magano, my first program. As yan, so ma-create na sa file. Then, namatay ko that print, for example. So, print hello pro. So aring yung run program niya. So, you try to test the program. So, as you can observe, there will be hello world here. So again, na medyo salaan nung ato niya, ano, no? Niya, very project natin sa test sample. Okay? Yeah. So, I have here the video naman, no? Itong ginasunod natin, no? So, kung ma-type sa hello world.
The run button at the top of the page. Hello world should appear at the console. Nice! You've just finished your first Python project. What you just saw was the print function in action. The print function prints the text within the parentheses on the console. You can input other text using this function. For example, this code would print, "I love cakes." Easy, right? Now let's talk about strings. In Python, we call a sequence of characters a string. In the print function, the text in the parentheses is an example of a string. Let's go back to our earlier example. The sentence, "I love cakes," is the string. And if you use single quotes instead of double, the effect will be the same. This will still print the string, "I love cakes," on the console. Well done! That concludes our discussion. Let's have a quick recap. In this video, we learned about using Python and PyCharm to create our own project, the print function, and strings. In the next video, we'll be tackling variables.
Okay, so as you can observe, no, pwede ka mali ka butang, pwede ka mali ka gamit sang single quote, or you can use also double quote. No, sa ito niya, ginay mo. Okay? Yeah. So, the next discussion will be on the variable naman. So, anyway, may mga videos naman eh. So, I'll just show it to you kung paano. Wait lang. So I have already finished this. So, yeah. So we have a variable. So si video na lang ako na pwede discuss. Anyway, ano man lang, most probably ano naman ini atong i-discuss. Okay, sige.
Variables. Variables are containers for data. They can be named almost anything. There are not many restrictions except that the first character of your variable name cannot be a digit. Variables are equivalent to a certain value, which can be a string or a number. Think of variables as boxes. Imagine that you're moving out of your parents' house. You'll have to pack all your stuff into boxes. Some of them contain shoes or books or clothes you definitely should have thrown out years ago. Variables are kind of like that. To avoid a cluttered text editor, a single box can contain a numerical value, a string of just one word, or the first 10 pages of The Hobbit. How do we declare variables? In Python, there is no specific command or keyword for creating a variable. You simply assign a value to something and then print it. Here are some examples. Let's assign the value of 7 to x and the string cake to y as shown in our code. Then print x and y using the print function. This should print 7 and cake. X and y here are what we call variables. We assign the values of a number and a string to x and y. In the next example, instead of inputting values manually, we use variables to automatically replace parts of our text. Consider this code. Now, what if we want to change our story? Instead of cakes, my new favorite food is pizza. And what if Joe and I had a fight? Now I'll be eating my pizza with a new friend. Let's call her Tina. Tina prefers drinking soda. Let's change milkshakes to soda. Should we change every single word per line of code? That would probably take a while. So let's declare our variables. Then we'll add these variables to the strings using a convenient trick called string concatenation. Like math, you can add strings using the addition symbol or the addition operator. Be careful with white space and punctuation. Let's go to our first line of code. Change cakes to the variable favorite_food. Again, don't forget about your spaces and punctuation marks. It should print, "I like pizza" on the console. Did you get it right? Okay, let's try the other lines of code. Using our variables and string concatenation, we can change the sentences. Let's write the code.
Okay, if you try to observe our video and the sample code that is already presented, no? If you observe, there will be no such thing as a specific data type here on on the declaring a variable. Unlike C, C++, Java, you need to declare the appropriate and exact data type in order for our value to be also recognized as the assign operator on the specific variable. No, so that's the typical programming language that we have already encountered on our previous subjects that you have already passed. No, but here in Python, as long as you declare it on a certain single quote or double quote, automatically the Python programming language will just interpret it as a string. Okay, since nga, as I have said no sa atong previous discussion, so since the Python is purely an interpreter type of a programming language no, so gina-interpret niya na kada may ma-encounter sa single quote or double quote, automatically it will become a string. Na kung wala siya sa single quote or even a double quote, so purely nag-type kadabi, for example, number lang, without any using those kinds of punctuations, I mean quotations, kung nagbuta mo na 20, then i-interpret nyo na as integer, but if you put some decimal, I mean fractional numbers on it, let's say for example 35.6, then it will be considered a full or double. So gin-interpret na sa automatically nyo. Just like PHP, and I think JavaScript, no, gaan mo mana sila. No. And same with Laravel, since Laravel was created by, came from the PHP na naging mo lang sa framework ni PHP para lain naman ang iyan ng mga codes, no, object-oriented. So let's continue, lapit naman na.
The code would print, I like eating cakes with my friend Tina. And we like to drink soda too. Let's have a quick recap. In this video, we learned about variables, declaring variables, and using variables to change data.
That's it for today. In the next lesson, we will be talking about syntax and errors.
Okay. So next naman ta, after the variable. So this is the last part, and then I will give you an exercise.
Syntax and errors. Programming languages are just like regular languages, in the sense that it also has a set of rules. Just like how you can face endless ridicule on the internet with a single typo on an otherwise well-written essay, one mistake in your code is enough to make the whole thing meaningless. So let's discuss the syntax of Python to avoid errors.
Let's say you're working with a big group. You'd probably go insane if, after working on the project for weeks, you saw an unfamiliar line of code and have no idea what it's about.
That's why comments are important. When you run your project, comments are completely ignored. They're entirely for the use of programmers like you. To make a comment, all you need to do is use the pound sign. Here are some examples. In Python, indentation is extremely important because we use them to create a new block of code. In JavaScript, for example, you can set a new block of code using curly braces. Here, all it takes is a bit of white space or the space around your code. If you want indents, simply press the spacebar repeatedly or use the tab key.
Indented blocks are also preceded by a colon on the previous line.
Here's an example. In JavaScript or C++, you would need to add a semicolon to end your statements. This isn't necessary for Python, because simply ending the line of code lets you end the statement.
Consider this. These two are already separate lines of code.
Parentheses indicate that a function is being called. The parentheses in the print function indicate that we need to put something within them.
They can also be used in mathematical operations, which we will be discussing in a future tutorial.
Now, if for some reason these rules are not followed, this could result in an error, which is why we need to be careful about writing our code.
It could be difficult to find what went wrong, especially if you've already written long blocks of code. Fortunately, some text editors indicate the issue by highlighting the syntax, so hopefully it won't be too big of a problem.
And there you have it! Now you know the basic syntax of Python. In this video, we learned about syntax, comments, indentation, ending your statement, parentheses, and errors. That's all for today, folks. See
you. Okay, so that is how the syntax on and errors for the Python. As I have said, no, Python is a case sensitive type of of programming language. I think still the same with the other programming languages. The only difference is that we need to follow the certain rules with regards to this kind of programming language, which is the Python. No, as moving along on the lessons with regards to the Python, and you will you will I mean familiarize no the other structure of the excuse me of the Python programming language na no? You will find out that the indentation magsiling indentation niyang structure kung diyan sa ma-place na no? Once you press the enter then let's say for example the indent will be half of the inch of the editor of your IDE. So meaning you need to follow. So once you move something no that is not considered as a structure of the Python programming language, so it will create e error or somehow it is called syntax and error no. So mo nang iya nga nya ano gid no ang strength lang ang somehow ang mga disadvantages sa aton nga Python kay gina-interpret sa according sa rules ang iyang structure unlike C, C++, Java maski ang tanan mo nga code wala indent no as in puro tanan nara sa kilid ang inyo yung mga code wala man siyaga pangita gid sa niya din nga structure nga mga indentation the structure should be correct indentation should be like this or somewhat like this on the Python naman yung side ya it is very crucial naman yung side so miskin na no para gin sakto sa imo mga syntaxes da imo mga variable sakto man ni ang naka placement ko mo ni pero gag-error gapon. It's because of the structure nga dapat nga gina-interpret niya ni Python nga ang iya yung interpretation niya with regards to the codes nga para man niya sa iya. And then if you try to observe also, wala siya sang semicolon. No, unlike C, C++, Java, may mga semicolon sila at the end to terminate the ano, to terminate the statement. No? Ang maling ila yung nga orientation naman, no? Same with BB.net. BB.net wala man sang semicolon eh. Basta wala man yung permiso sa mga semicolon, no. So may mga RIA programming lang yun, just say nga wala nga gagamit sa semicolon. PHP ata is also using ano, semicolon, JavaScript, ano pa? C#, no. Gagamit man sa tanas mga semicolon. Ang mga wala lang ganyan gamit naman na si DB.net, Visual Basic.net, and I think this programming language also not, is not using semicolon. Okay? So for your exercises code, then tomorrow, may another exercise code naman. Another lesson, another exercise code naman. So for your first exercise code na, where are you? Yes. Coding exercise. So your coding exercise is okay, i-stop nyo lang kung ano no, kung video na to. Okay? So instruction. Considering the following text, there was once a pilot who loved adventure. The pilot would take her plane to unknown places. She brings home a lot of fruits. No? Then she goes home to her pet lion. Lion yun dyan, no? So the name of the lion is Chuckles. Continue. Using a variable and string concatenation, so which is already described and discussed on the video example, change the following details of the story. So character, job, pilot to pirate. The character ride plane to ship. Character souvenir puts to gold and pet lion from the pack. So doon mo nang inyong i-change, no? So that is the mechanics of the instruction of decoding exercise. Another instruction example, variable, favorite food, spaghetti, string concatenation, naman siya. And I think just repeat lang no, the video that I have here. So that you can review what is the string concatenation using the variable. Yeah. So open a pie chart and try out yung exercise for yourself. Proceed to the next page when you're done. So siyempre hindi yun ipag-consider. Just open your PyCharm, do the same that I have on the instruction no? With the regards opening and creating a pipe. Okay, so I'll be checking the exercises when we see on our next meeting that will be on week number 4 because I will not be around somehow on tomorrow because I mean Thursday, that will be me too. I will be do some emergency, no? I need to leave for a while, no? Me Thursday. That will be on Thursday. But I will be but we will be meeting on HTML development on Friday. Okay, so sa dali lang ganyan daw. So need to get mag-leave. And on the last week, the week number 4 that we have on excuse me, on May 7, also ma-meet man ko da sa inyo. Okay. So muna tong exercise, no? So kindly please just repeat this video para maano ta, para maka-create sa natin niya first exercise. And oh, by the way, no, so next meeting tama yara ta, please. So I will be uploading the content of our discussion here. So I'm just preparing first the, ano, the presentation. Anyway, the presentation here on the introductory, i-upload ko muna. Ang wala ko na naman upload is the, ano, ang ininga mga presentations that I have together with the video. Okay, so see you next meeting, guys. I mean, see you on Friday on HTML development. Bye!